The new moon shall rule the sky soon enough.
Shall burn in the dragon's fire.
The people will join us eventually.
Over here, Walker. This was written by the clan mother. Could be important. Seems there's more to Pride Home than we thought. The pride of Alkosh. Forgotten manes who protect the threads of time, hidden away in this modest temple. Makes sense. This pride of Alkosh protects elsewhere in times of great need. Dragon. Wish I knew, Walker. We could certainly... You'll find Zaji further ahead. He heard some bells and went running off. Quite bold. Not good, if that's what you're asking. Many of the moon priests are already dead, and the cult has spread throughout Pride Home. Agreed. Whatever they're after.
Hey, look at this! A letter from Mother! It's peculiar, isn't it? This one knew Mother could read, but he never saw her write. How does she hold the quip? A demon from the east, the pride of Alkosh. What is Mother going on about? Well, this one remembers something about the pride of Alkosh. They were warriors born during an eclipse, made them more sensitive to time and the call of the moons. For some, they follow a difficult path, Walker. Born under dark moons, the drum of Lorkaj calls to them clearly. Maybe Mother holds the quill in her mouth? No idea. Mother's temple worships Kenathi, while Pride Home appears dedicated to Alkosh. They're both of the...
One of Zaji's favorites.
There was once a Khajiiti warrior, blessed by Alkosh himself. She fought a mighty demon, drenched in ice and death. Though the warrior was able to trap the demon away, she did not survive the battle. Zaji was getting to that part. The warrior's corpse was taken to Kenarthi's breath temple, where the moon priests prayed over her body for 4 days and 4 nights. On the fourth night, when both moons were full, Kenarthi herself appeared. With a single swipe of Kenarthi's paw, the warrior's spirit rose from her corpse. Together, they flew into the sky, past the sands behind the stars, and went to a place beyond all that is known. There, Alkosh welcomed his warrior home.
So the legend says, but a Khajiiti tale is as reliable as, say, a harlot's affection. One should not...
Just keep the pressure there, and you should be all right.
Thank you, young Zhaal. You are with the Dragon Guard, yes? Do you, Rakajin? No. He was raised in this temple. We were brothers in all but blood. And yet, he's the one causing all this death, all this destruction. It cannot be true. Oh, they seek the clan mother. Noziwa does not know why.
Sai Sahan went on ahead. Tell him about the clan mother while I get this one back on his feet.
The cultist moved through Prideholm swiftly. I suspect more await us beyond this gate. The moon priest here didn't even possess weapons to defend themselves with. What? A Khajiit-i wise woman? Perhaps they seek her knowledge. It's said the clan mothers keep many secrets to themselves, often deceiving others with half-truths and riddles. Then let's hope we get to her before the cult does. The inner temple is just ahead. Let's move. Bubbles. Nephilar. Decided to show up after all. Death. What could possibly warrant this massacre?
You can count on us.
Sept scales. See if she's still breathing.
The Dragon Guard comes to our aid, and the threads intertwine once more. Izuni has one song left in her, though she may be too weak to sing it. Then you must listen. Once a cub was born under the eclipsed moons, destined not to lead as Mane, but to join the pride of Alkosh. We trained him as a holy warrior, a hidden protector. But that was not enough for Rakajin. Yes, but greed poisoned his heart. He wanted to rule over elsewhere, not protect it. Then the demon from the east returned. No time. Alkosh, grant me a moment more. The mask, you...
Step away, Dragon Guard. She has passed on. The clan mother spoke of the statue. We should examine it. Yes, of course. The statue wears a mask, doesn't it? What did the inscription tell you? Jadari? As in the Horn of Jadari? It seems Nephilar has some explaining to do. This Jadari must be part of the pride of Alkosh, perhaps even its founder. The Clan Mother requested we find the mask before Rakajin does, so I can only assume it's a relic of great power. Something. Then let's see what our resident Red Beast thinks of all this. Hopefully Nephilar is still nearby. Too late. She's dead.
How could Rakajin do this? Hisuni was a mother to him. To both of us.
Fate will catch up with Rakajin eventually. We'll avenge.
Vengeance means little to the dead, Dragon God. I have come. For all the good it accomplished. The Mask of Alkosh. Lord Vulan is a fool. His pathetic priest will never be worthy of such a relic. Not like Jadari. Jadari. I called her Toshrakat, the founder of Prideholm, and the first of Alkosh's pride. She once wore the mask, yes. And I suspect her corpse guards it still. But none of this matters. Then learn the truth for yourself. If you seek the mask, speak with the Clan Mother of Kanarthi. It was her temple that cared for Jadari's remains. Seek the mask if you wish. I will deal with Lot Vulan.
Another trip to Mother's temple.
Oh no, I am not dealing with another one of your bouts of depression. Ilya will go.
I will? I mean, of course I will.
It's settled. You two will head to Kanarthi's temple and search for the mask. Kaska, Zaji, you're with me.
Pardon the intrusion, Clan Mother, but we bring distressing news.
You speak of Prideholm, yes? And the death of Hisuni.
You already know?
This one heard whispers on the wind. Make Narthi carry her to sweeter sands. Though Tidali consents the winds of death, she is blind to your motives. Tell this one, Dragon Guard. Yes, this temple cared for Jadari's remains long ago. You seek the halls of the Hymen, a most sacred place. Even if Rakajin finds the mask, it would reject him. She did. Then perhaps Izuni saw something in the tapestry of time that this one has yet to hear in the wind. You will find a bell stand by the statue, much like the one in our temple's courtyard. After so many years of neglect, Tidali is sure the bells are heavily tarnished.
The halls of the Hymen. Sounds rather ominous, doesn't it? I don't think this will be a simple jaunt through some ruins. Yes, I know the statue. Zaji and I passed by it the last time we were in Black Heights. It seemed to unsettle him, but he wouldn't tell me why. Well, no time to ask him now. I'll meet you by... Of course I want to go with you. You'll need assistance, won't you? I know that I might not be the strongest of the Dragon Guard, or the most experienced, or even the most resourceful. Trust me, I'm aware of my shortcomings. But I can still help. I'm sorry, it's just... I can't help but feel like I've let you all down. Yagrandu was dead by the time we arrived. Could I have done something to find him sooner? And it may not sound reasonable, but I can't help it. It's easy to doubt myself after so many failures. These bells look just like the ones in Kanarthi's Breath Temple. And look, they're all tarnished. Clan Mother Tidali was right. The bells are tarnished from neglect. Why don't we... Clan Mother... I imagine... We need to hit the big bells in the same order as the little bells. They should be around here somewhere.
He calls to you with gentle winds. She can guide you, but never carry you. With the drums of Lortage beat strongly, darkness creeps into your heart and death claws at your throat. With strength, with courage, you must find the light. Elkosh watches with a steady eye. His wayward children have forgotten their purpose and threaten to destroy the natural way. With reverence, with virtue, you must claim his mask and mend the threads of time. Will you walk the path with pride? Gennarthi's sweet winds, Lortage's black heart, light to follow, and darkness to thwart. Cunning and strength, virtue and pride, may they prove worthy of mask divine. The way is opened, and so Tadali's part in this ends. It is up to you now, Dragon Guard.
Our first trial. Looks like we'll have to find a way across. Those poles certainly look like grappling points, don't they? Perhaps. A grappling bow, of course. I confiscated this one from Zaji back in Senchal, but I forgot to return it to Sai Sahan. We just have to hope there's another path.
Door just opened. I'll meet you on the other side. Good work. Now let's see if we can find that mask. Climb.
Grandmother Tadali said you had to find light in darkness. Why don't you try igniting the braziers?
Shrine. Seems like we're on the right path.
Only two more to go.
Thank you.
ready to fight.
living stones. Casca told me about these. You move them onto panels to unlock gates. this is the last of these trials. Come on, the mask should be just ahead. That's a statue of Jadari, isn't it? Let's see if there's an inscription.
You have both ventured far and come so close, but only one may claim the mask of Alkosh. You who heard the Clan Mother's dying words, go now and claim that which you earned.
Was that Jadari? Well, Jadari has spoken. Only one hero can claim the mask, and that hero seems to be you, which makes complete sense, of course. I could go back to Sai Sahan and report in, but that doesn't feel right to me. You're right. I need to focus on my strengths if I want to help the Dragon Guard. I've always been good with diplomacy. Perhaps I can help gather allies. The Shields of Senshaw? Do you really think they would join us? Well...
Show me your worth.
challenge. Very well, brother. Let us end this.